paradise, but man, foolish man, wanted more out of life. So he bit the apple to become wise. There he stood naked. He realized that when he opened his eyes, he was still really blind. See, in the beginning, he had tranquility. Now he has negativity, responsibility, and enemies. Open our eyes.
Open our eyes.
With wisdom came shame, with shame came pain.
Open our eyes.
Open our eyes. Ah, but at the end of the tunnel, I see a light. The light that exists in all of us, yet at the same time, in none of us.
Give us the light.
Open our eyes.
Give us the light.
You see now, we think too much. We don't feel. Close your eyes and open your inner ones. Open your eyes. Raise your hands if you understand. And open your eyes. And feel. Close your eyes, close your eyes. And open your inner self. Receive the light. Open your eyes. Raise your hands, if you understand. And receive the light. Close your eyes. Feel all that's around you. Receive the light. Open your inner eyes. Beauty around you. If you just see and feel with your inner selves, give us the light.
Give us the light.
your hands if you understand.
Thank you. We'll be right back. Thank you. The earth is a living being. The earth has given birth. The earth has given birth to the plant kingdom, to the animal kingdom, to the human kingdom. We're all part of a living being.
Thank you. space, intelligence, and technology in that micro moment of geological time that we call history that will precede the emergence of human nature perfected in a kind of techno-shamanic community in a virtual cultural space beyond our present capacity to even conceive of and imagine.
Thank you. Wisdom is what you are, knowledge is what you know.
When you burst in, when you burst in
to the center of the psychedelic mandala.
When you burst in,
this amazing sense of satisfaction. An ecology of souls.
As you break into that space, they come toward you shouting hooray in a new way.
In a new way.
Hooray. Words in the domain of the machine elves are not things heard, but things seen.
Ideas swim before your eyes like tropical reef fish. Concepts rain like snowflakes.
Conceptuality flexes and uncoils before you like some kind of hyperdimensional cephalopod.
And these objects themselves are singing. And these objects themselves are singing.
You sound them to work on a piece of space, to color it gold, to drill holes through it, to polish it.
Watch what we are doing.
Do what we are doing.
Do it now. Do it. Do it. Do it. adventure some kind of ultimate meaning.
Unfolding of the human imagination. This is our destiny. This is what our ancestors struggled to give to us as an opportunity, and this is the domain which we must secure if we are to give the human adventure some kind of ultimate meaning.
During the typical psychedelic drug session, the subject reports being tumbled through a complex history of evolution. In 1 second, we lie pulsating as a single cell. In the next second, ancient memories of mammalian existence sweep over your consciousness. These days, there is an avalanche of publicity about the effects of marijuana and LSD My advice is don't listen to any of the propaganda, whether it's positive or negative. Don't believe what you read in the papers. And don't listen to general statements. In this time of hysteria and crisis, we must do what men have always done in such times. Listen to your friends and trust your own judgment. During any 1 second of an LSD session, consciousness can whirl through all five levels: sleep, symbol, sense, self, and soul. 1,000 microscopes, 1,000 telescopes, 1,000 blindfolds, 1,000 symbols spinning through awareness at each instant.
Yes, the world may be coming to the end, but we still have our feelings about it. So the respect for our own feelings, or the empowerment of our own bodies and our own feelings, is really important.
We'll be right back. civilization is impossible without communication.
Declaration of the independence of cyberspace. Governments of the industrial world, you weary giants of flesh and steel, I come from cyberspace, the new home of mind. On behalf of the future, I ask you of the past to leave us alone. You are not welcome among us. You have no sovereignty where we gather. We have no elected government, nor are we likely to have one, so I address you with no greater authority than that with which liberty itself always speaks. I declare the global social space we are building to be naturally independent of the tyrannies you seek to impose on us. You have no moral right to rule us, nor do you possess any methods of enforcement we have true reason to fear. Governments derive their just powers from the consent of the governed. You have neither solicited nor received ours. We did not invite you. You do not know us, nor do you know our world. Cyberspace does not lie within your borders. Do not think that you can build it, as though it were a public construction project. You cannot. It is an act of nature and it grows itself through our collective actions. You have not engaged in our great and gathering conversation, nor did you create the wealth of our marketplaces. You do not know our culture, our ethics, or the unwritten codes that already provide our society more order than could be obtained by any of your impositions. Cyberspace consists of transactions, relationships, and thought itself, arrayed like a standing wave in the web of our communications. Ours is a world that is both everywhere and nowhere, but it is not where bodies live. We are creating a world that all may enter without privilege or prejudice accorded by race, economic power, military force, or station of birth. We are creating a world where anyone, anywhere may express his or her beliefs, no matter how singular, without fear of being coerced into silence or conformity. Your legal concepts of property, expression, identity, movement, and context do not apply to us. They are based on matter. There is no matter here. In our world, all the sentiments and expressions of humanity, from the debasing to the angelic, are parts of a seamless whole, the global conversation of bits. We cannot separate the air that chokes from the air upon which beings beat. In China, Germany, France, Russia, Singapore, Italy and the United States, you are trying to ward off the virus of liberty by erecting guard posts at the frontiers of cyberspace. These may keep out the contagion for a small time, but they will not work in a world that will soon be blanketed in bit-bearing media. These increasingly hostile and colonial measures place us in the same position as those previous lovers of freedom and self-determination who had to reject the authorities of distant, uninformed powers. We must declare our virtual selves immune to your sovereignty, even as we continue to consent to your rule over our bodies. We will spread ourselves across the planet so that no one can arrest our thoughts. We will create a civilization of the mind in cyberspace. May it be more humane and fair than the world your governments have made before.
Thank you. no one's slave. I am no one's master. No one's slave. I am no one's master. On my grave they will write this after I am gone. I will be gone, and then my flesh will go to the earth it lived on. Breath will go to the air it lived from. I am through with the shame of my lying. I've had my fill of the cruelty and cry. Earned my keep in the land where the dying deserts grow. And now I know, and I am looking out with a new perspective, listening out for a new directive, going home to the land of our mothers. I will walk with my sisters and brothers. We will share what is good with each other.
Human heart can go the lengths of God. Dark and cold we may be, but this is no winter now. The frozen misery of centuries cracks, breaks, begins to move. The thunder is the thunder of the flows, the thaw, the flood, the upstart spring. Thank God our time is now. When wrong comes up to face us everywhere, never to leave us, till we take the longest stride of soul men ever took. Affairs on our soul sides. Enterprise is exploration into God. Where are you? It takes so many thousand years to wake, but will you wake? Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
I think without a doubt you're the weirdest looking one here tonight.
I can't take any more. All this sensuous excitement in one evening.
Thank you. is life. Wherever you apprehend life, there is death. You are alive. In you is this being who can say, I am. A little bit of God.
Thank you. middle of your chest. And that even though you're breathing in and out of your nose and your mouth, necessary oxygen, etc., with each in-breath into this hole in your chest, you are drawing something very subtle, not even on the physical plane. It's been called soma. It's been called elixir. It's been called ambrosia. It's been called pran. It's been called living spirit. Think of it as a very fine mist. With each breath, draw it into the middle of your chest and let it pour through your body to the extremities, to the tips of your fingers, to the tips of your toes, through your torso, your head. And then in the out-breath, when you're breathing out through the center of your chest, any stuff in you that is keeping you from being with the universe, the tensions, the fears, the negativity, the doubt, the grudges, the anger, the loneliness, the self-pity, breathe it out. Just breathe it out. Let it go on the out-breath. And then fill once again with this healing, very fine mist, and let it pour through your body. And let the, as it pours through your body, let it dislodge the tensions that may have settled in your back or in your stomach. The heavy thoughts, thoughts of paranoia, feelings of inadequacy, of doubt, the judging mind, just let it all be loosened, dislodged, and on the out-breath, breathe it out. Make the breath slow and deep, and keep that imagery very strongly in mind, that you're drawing in a very fine mist, filling your being, and then releasing all of the stuff you don't need to be in the spirit. Thank you. universe, listen now, drawing the universe into your heart, the middle of your chest, and you will breathe out through the top of your head, going out with your breath, go up with your breath, and go back into the formless. And then on the next in-breath, draw the formless down into your heart. And then with the out-breath, breathe it out through your heart and recreate the forms which are spirit made manifest. Then with the in-breath, draw it back into your heart. Breathe out through the top of your head, going up. If you are resting above your head, then draw the breath in, come back down into your heart, and then manifest out into the world. So it's in, up, out, down, in, out. Do that for a few minutes. Start very slow, deep breathing. So you keep going between four, between the one and the many.
Whoever comes to mind,
bring their image before you, standing or sitting or being out in front. With your breath, go up above your head, letting yourself go out through your top of your head. Again, bring that fine mist, that spirit down through the top of your head, the formless, down into your heart. And then on the out-breath, send it out, keeping that being in mind. And with your mind, imagining, surrounding that being with light. That is peace. That is healing. That is love. That is spacious. Then go back up into the formless until that is just pouring through your heart. Out and surrounding that being or those beings. world and become a conduit for the living spirit to be manifest.
Thank you.